Stop it.
Sunday, June 7, 2015. This miniature schnauzer male, not neutered, 8 years old, has this, what's the main complaint? The salivation, saliva come out.
Yeah.
And bad breath.
Bad breath.
And how about leaking? You're saying about leaking?
Yeah, leaking. I mean, leaking. This one has been for many years. La. It's been
leaking,
leaking of
the toes.
Yeah.
Both sides, right?
Yeah, both sides.
Okay, the thing is that the thing is the bad breath is very bad. Now, you can even smell it from far away. Now, the groomer did some dental extraction and some loose teeth were done. But this one, you can see the roots are exposed. You can see the roots there. And this is a stage 4. Where the ligaments are already loose, already detached. Eh? So you can see the gums are all red. Do you see the gums are all red?
Yeah.
All these ulcers. So this would be caused, be the cause of bad breath. It's like people, when they have mouth ulcers, they have bad breath. There are all these ulcers. This root also exposed. And this one is bad. This is normally the gum tip up to this level. These are the roots. So the roots are really
exposed.
That's why there's a decay here. So the breath is a bad disease. So the things that we need to do under anesthetic, and if the tooth is loose, the exposed teeth, the big ones are premolars, then we have to extract it out. Because it's already loose already. So all depends on how bad it is. You see the inflammation?
Yeah.
This one, the root is also exposed. Normally, it's up to
this
here.
This one, is it normal or is it like bulb?
All these are roots exposed.
No, but this one is a swell or what?
Yeah, this is a starting of a tumor, we call it. Dogs with back teeth, after a certain period of time, they develop gum tumors. Or they call it the gum tumors. Normally, due to bad oral hygiene. So you are right, you are quite observant, you notice this. So if you delay, it will become bigger and bigger and bigger. So you can see it very bad.
Okay.
So the best is even you ask the groomer to do, but groomer can't do much for such cases. Now the thing is we will put under IV drip and give antibiotic first because there's a lot of bacteria inside. And so there's a fever, so we can't do today. So today we will just give the IV drips, antibiotics, painkiller first. Then you can bring back. Then when you have 3 days or 4 days later, then we'll do the dental, that's the one way. The other way is we do tomorrow after checking whether there's fever or not.
Because now there's fever cannot be.
Yeah, you might die under the anesthetic and then.
Oh. But the fever tomorrow will go off?
Normally it does with the antibiotics,
okay.
IV, but if you're not then.